Welcome, boxing fans. This is Boxing with the Truth. And this is The Truth with another segment of Who's Who in Boxing. It's the Fall Brawl, October 19th, Black Bear Casino, Carlton, Minnesota. Let's start from the bottom to the top. First off, we got light middleweights Mark Connor making his debut. He's actually a boxing writer. That's right, folks, a boxing writer. Sits behind a desk and writes about boxing. But don't be fooled, he actually has over 100 amateur fights. But he hasn't boxed in 19 years. But he still has the skill set. He's fighting Damian Hill, MMA fighter turned pro boxer, 0-3. He has power, he has skill, but he hasn't won a pro boxing match yet. Mark Connor is coming to finish his bucket list. Damon Hill is on the bucket list. Mark Connor definitely has the boxing experience. If he comes, gets past the nerves in the first or second round, he will probably outpoint and outbox Damon Hill. If he can't shake the nerves and Damon Hill comes out fast, strong, puts him into the ropes, in the corners, and makes him fight fast, Damian Hill will get his first win as a pro boxer. It's all going to come down to who's going to be the smarter fighter and who's going to use their skills best. I think if Mark Connor doesn't get beat in the first two rounds, if Damian Hill doesn't take him out, Mark Connor will definitely outbox him in this four-round fight. Fight two, welterweights. Marcus Morris making his debut. He is definitely a skilled fighter, folks. If you have not seen him as an amateur, he has fought some of the best competition in the state of Minnesota. He has power. He can fight from angles. He will stand in the middle and trade with you. He will out-jab you. The one thing I see that he does not do every fight is he does not put all his power behind his punches. That could be his one weakness in this fight. If he does not drive through his punches, Cooley, his opponent, who's also making his debut, will be able to stand there for the four rounds and he could possibly outpoint him. But Marcus Morris, in his last couple amateur fights before turning pro, did put power on the end of his punches and he did knock out his opponent in his last amateur fight. Cooley is a Muay Thai fighter. I don't know much about him. He won't be using his feet in this fight. I know that much. So if Marcus Morris does get him in the middle of the ring and does get him in trouble trading, I don't know if he has enough boxing experience to stay with Marcus Morris. But I don't know how much boxing experience he really has. So it could end up being a short night for Cooley, depending on what he chooses to do. If he stays around in the middle of the ring, it's going to be an early night for him. If he moves and tries to hit Marcus Morris from angles, he possibly has a chance in this four-round fight. Let's move to the next fight. Light middleweights, Corey Collateral Damage Rodriguez, 7-3-3. This man has a chip on his shoulder, and I don't blame him. For some reason, boxing fans, promoters, trainers, and some other fighters do not give this man the respect he deserves. I don't know why. He's a good fighter. He has skills. He has powers. He's a nice guy out of the ring, but he just doesn't get the respect. And then once again in this fight against Steven Watt, 2-1, an MMA fighter turned pro boxer, he's not getting the respect again. So folks, look for him to come out and get his respect in this fight. He's crafty, he will stand and brawl, he can fight smart, he has power, but the one thing I do see Steven Watt having is power as well. Steven Watt's going to come and try and end this fight early. He's going to come and try and knock Corey Rodriguez out because, personally, folks, Corey Rodriguez just has too much skill for him. He has too much experience. He could outpoint him, he can outbox him, it could go the full six rounds, but I see Corey Rodriguez winning a decision if it does. Steven Watts needs to come out fast, strong, throw power, bully Corey Rodriguez against the ropes, in the corners, keep him out of the middle of the ring, and he could possibly end this fight early with a knockout. If he does not do that, he will lose by a decision in 6 rounds. Simple as that. To the next fight, super featherweights, Ismael Mwendo, 14-0 with 11 knockouts. Folks, if you have not seen this man fight, you definitely want to come and fight. He's crisp. He shoots from angles. He will brawl. He will box. He just is so classy in the ring. He's like a painting, a moving painting in the ring. You love to watch this man fight. And he is the nicest guy outside the ring. He came here from Uganda to win a world title, and he's just steps away from doing that. He is fighting Eric Aiken, a former champion, who is 16-10 with 12 knockouts. Eric Aiken has had trouble in the last few fights he's been in. They've been ended early, and he took the losses. Whether he just stepped up for paychecks or not is not for me to say, but before that, he was on a roll of wins dominating fights. He is looking at this fight as a comeback fight to prove he's still a world champion and that Ismael Mwendo does not belong in the same ring with him. Ismael Mwendo is here to prove that he can beat a former world champion and he could eventually beat a world champion to become a world champion. So folks, you do not want to miss this fight. It is an 8-round fight, but I do not see it going 8 rounds. It could be ended by either man in less than 8. Depending on who comes out and fights their fight. Eric Aiken has the experience. He has fought the better fighters. But Ismael Mwendo is climbing the ladder quick, folks. You do want to come and see this man before he no longer is around to watch. Because he's fighting for a world title out in Las Vegas or somewhere else. Next fight, cruiserweight. Al the Haitian Temptation Sands. If you have not heard this name in Minnesota, you are not a boxing fan, folks. He is 10-1 with 10 knockouts. He is the Minnesota Cruiserweight Champion. Some people say he has not been tested yet. So he is fighting Bobby Thomas Jr., who's 12-1 with 9 knockouts. This will be the biggest test of Al Sands' career. They both have heavy hands. They both like to throw body shots. They both come to fight. There will be no dancing in this fight, folks. This fight is going to be a fight. Bobby Thomas likes to throw body shots, but he leans in periodically. If he leans in too much, Al Sands will catch it and end the night with an uppercut. Al Sands is a student of the game. He will take the first round. He will let his opponent come at him. He will study him. The second and third round, he will expose his mistakes and possibly end this fight. If Bobby Thomas Jr. comes out smart, stays away, and studies Al like Al studies his opponent, it could be a long night for both of them. It's going to be a chess match, folks, if Bobby Thomas comes out smart. If he doesn't, if he comes to knock Al Sands' head off, it's going to be a short night. It could end in 2-3 rounds. But it's definitely worth the price of the ticket to watch Al Sands get tested. Main event, folks. Super middleweights, Matt the Predator Vanda. If you have not heard this name in the state of Minnesota, you are not a boxing fan. You need to go on BoxRec right now and look up in who this man is. He has fought Andy Coley. He has fought Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. twice. Irish John Duddy, Phil Williams, Peter Manfredo Jr., Marco Antonio Rubio, Caleb Truex. The list goes on and on, folks. This man is the definition of a fighter. He comes to the ring with Harleys following him. Actual motorcycles, folks. He is a true fighter. He comes to fight. There will be no dancing in this fight. He's fighting Brooke Welby, 35-19 with 11 knockouts. Matt Vanda is 44-15 with 24 knockouts. Brooke Welby is a southpaw. He could possibly give Matt Vanda some problems in the beginning, but Matt Vanda has fought too much competition to let a southpaw slow him down. This is a 10-round fight. Brooke Welby's coming all the way from Canada. He is a tough Canadian, folks. He could possibly be the Canada's Matt Van. Get your tickets now. These are all going to be great matchups. The truth has spoken.